So for quite a long time, people built portfolios this way. They would look at a bunch of assets, essentially equally weight them, and end up with a portfolio that behaves somewhat in between. Now, if you wanted a low-risk portfolio, you should focus on assets that are low-risk out here. If you wanted, for instance, high return, you should focus on assets over here. And in both those cases, you would end up with a portfolio, you know, say here, or a portfolio, say here. Now, can we do better? In other words, is it possible to get portfolios over here? So can we have a portfolio here that has a return similar to these assets over here, but risk similar to these assets over here? Indeed we can, and it's due to a man named Harry Markowitz, who won the Nobel Prize for his insight. What he discovered, and what people have been overlooking, was the relationship between stocks in terms of covariance. So the resulting performance of a portfolio, especially in terms of risk, is not just a factor or a blend of the various risks, but it has to do with how they interact day to day. So indeed, if we pick the right stocks in the right proportions, we can get a portfolio that performs over here that in fact can have lower risk than any of the individual assets. And I'll show you how to do that in just a moment. Before I do that, I want to mention, though, one other thing about Harry Markowitz. Up until the time of his discovery, most people viewed bonds as the lowest risk asset. In other words, if you wanted low risk, you should use bonds only. Markowitz showed that a blend of stocks and bonds is actually lower risk than either one of those by themselves. And I'll show you how that makes sense in a moment.